Hi guys, welcome to my channel Evolving Being. In today's video, we will talk about the undergraduate application process for Ashoka University. In the past, I've also covered how you should apply for the postgraduate level program, the Young India Fellowship. If you haven't seen that video, I'll link it up here. Please go and watch that as well. And here I will be covering the selection process, the fee structure, the different stages of application, etc. And towards the end, I will also be covering the one-time payments that students have to make and that they should keep in mind while they are applying to different universities. So watch till the end and don't forget to hit the like, share and subscribe button so that I know that you are getting regular updates on all the different aspects of higher education. On that note, let's get started. So before we begin, I would like to briefly introduce myself. I was a core member of the founding team that launched the undergraduate batch of Ashoka University. I was on the founding admissions panel as well. So I have interviewed hundreds and thousands of students along with founders and faculty members of Ashoka. I have also been on the admissions panel of the Young India Fellowship program. And I was also an alum of the YF program. I have seen the university grow from its very early days on, both as an alum as well as somebody who's helped build the institution. So I have a good understanding of what they are looking for in students while they are onboarding them, what their requirements are, and exactly how students should align themselves and their application in such a way so that they get selected into the university. A little bit about Ashoka University before we begin, in case you're not aware of it. Ashoka University is one of the pioneering universities in liberal arts in India. The aim is really to create well-rounded individuals who are able to think critically, who are able to speak effectively, and who are thoughtful leaders that have a passion for public service. And this philosophy of Ashoka reflects across various programs that the university has launched, both at the undergraduate level as well as the postgraduate level. The selection process for the undergraduate admissions is a three-stage process. Stage one is your application and your assessments. Now, the application is quite exhaustive, and it's probably the first time students at the school level are filling such a comprehensive application form. So you need to submit your SAT scores if you've written them, your ACT scores if you've got them, also your board results once they come out. You have essays that you need to write, there's a letter of recommendation, and all your academic and non-academic engagements need to go into the application form. So it's quite comprehensive, and you should keep aside at least 1 to 2 months to fill it in the best possible manner. Along with the application form, now it is also mandatory for everybody to write the Ashoka aptitude test as well as an on-the-spot essay. Now the aptitude test is a 90-minute long assessment and the essay is a 30-minute long exercise. Now this forms stage one of your selection process. Apart from stage one, once this is done, you move to stage two where you will be interviewed by an admissions panel of the university. You may have people at the director, at the assistant director level interviewing you from the admissions team, and you may also find faculty members interviewing you. Once you are selected, the stage three is where you will receive an offer of admission, and if you are a confirmed applicant, you will also receive the financial aid form. So the financial aid form becomes accessible only to those students who have been given an offer of admission. And now, you must also keep in mind that there are various different formats in which the admission decisions are made. So there are different, there are conditional offers, there are confirmed offers, and 4-5 more different categories. Next are your deadlines. So Ashoka's application form for the undergraduate admission began on 14th of October last year in 2020. Two rounds are already over. Currently we are in round 3, which closes on March 14th. And after this, there will be another last round, round 4, which will close on 14th of June. And a lot of students will apply after their decisions have come in, after their final results from the board exams, etc., of the different boards have come in. And those students can look at applying by 14th June as well. The annual tuition fee for Ashoka University is 8.25 lakh rupees. Apart from this, you also have the hostel fee, which is 1.67 lakh rupees. Now this adds up to a total amount of 9.87 lakh rupees. This is an annual fee structure. Over and above, in the first year while you are enrolling, there's a one-time payment of 50,000 rupees, which is the admissions fee. And you also have to make a security deposit of 75,000 rupees, which includes a refundable meal plan as well. So in the first year, when you take admission, you end up paying a total of 11.12 lakh rupees. Now, this is an important figure to keep in mind while you are considering your applications for different universities. Now, there are a whole lot of things that you need to understand better when you're applying to Ashoka. The first thing is how to fill the application form, which includes essays. Essays are so important and reflect such an important aspect of your personality. Now, you also have the Ashoka aptitude test, and you have your on-the-spot essays also. So how to approach all of this? If you want me to share tips and tricks on how you can look at each of these areas individually, and if you want personal guidance or assistance in filling up the application form or preparing for the interview process, feel free to write to me, as I'll be happy to help you and share more guidance on this, be it on this channel or personally as well. So that's all for now. I request all of you to like, share and subscribe to my channel so that you are updated on everything related to higher education sector. I will be sharing the processes for application forms for different universities also. So in case you have a particular university in mind, please mention it in the comment section below and I will take that up. And till we meet again in the next video, all the best for your application process. And don't forget to hit the like, share and subscribe button.